Goldust in a precarious position, hanging upside down, and the ever-aggressive Bret Hart borderlining on viciousness, stomping away at the solar plexus and the lower abdomen of a helpless Goldust.
And last night, no matter what Bret Hart did, no matter what the... Hey!
This is here.
What is this? This is trouble for Bret Hart. This is trouble. DOA. They don't care who they run over. They don't care, ladies and gentlemen. DOA coming down here. Well, maybe I spoke too soon. Maybe it's not trouble for Bret. Maybe it's trouble for Goldust.
The match is still going no matter what. Here come all the cycles.
And, oh, right in front of the motorcycles. And wait a minute. Here come the Hawks.
Oh, this is bad. This is bad. It's going to break loose any minute.
Stay with us, ladies and gentlemen. We shall return. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We're live from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. The entire Hart Foundation has come down to watch this matchup. And there you see members of DOA.
And why are the DOA here? That's my question.
Well, they have decided to ride on into town. And who's going to stop them? Goldust with Bret the... Oh! Bret the Hitman Hart, and they're battling out all amongst that metal. Bret sending Goldust into the apron and into the ring. The Hitman Bret Hart with tremendous support here tonight. Live from Edmonton, what kind of support will Bret Hart have next week in San Antonio?
I don't think it's going to be too cordial. Deep in the heart of Texas, you don't mess with Texas.
And oh! Bret Hart, one, two, and he got him. No, he didn't, no.
Well, we know the Hart Foundation is down here to make sure that none of the members of DOA interfere in this match. But who is DOA down here to interfere with? Is it Bret Hart or is it Goldust? What are they doing? They're just looking.
Oh! And earlier on, we saw DOA and the Bariquas go at it. For those of you who just joined us, the Bariquas, unfortunately, one of them suffered an injury when he was dropped across one of the motorcycles of DOA. And now, Goldust turning it back around. Goldust, who was a part of that 10-man tag team war last night in your house. Here's the cover, the count, and Bret Hart kicking out.
Goldust able to use that point of his elbow and driving it right down into Bret Hart, and now the 6'6", 260-pound former Intercontinental Champion trying to use leverage to maintain an advantage against the Hitman.
Goldust trying to pull off what would be somewhat of an upset, and wait a minute. Oh no, we're being joined by more individuals. Top wrist lock here, but meanwhile, here comes LLD. Here comes Ken Shamrock. And things are about to bust loose here in Edmonton, Alberta.
Well, I think they're down here to watch Goldust back.
And the Americans have not been greeted very warmly by this partisan Canadian crowd. Oh, look at that man's eyes. Bret Hart must be distracted. Goldust, for that matter, must be distracted. Here we go, clothesline. A cover and a kick out by the Hitman.
Another near fall by Goldust on the legendary Bret the Hitman Hart. Goldust with his, he has Texas roots as well.
Goldust working in the midsection of the Hitman. Hitman, what a ride. Oh no, 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 look out. Stone Cold Steve Austin at the top of the ramp.
It's like walking through a room full of dynamite, smoking a big old cigar. You know it's gonna blow up any minute right in your face.
Oh, a kick out. Bret Hart and Goldust going at it. And you expect that spark to ignite a whole case of dynamite.
But who's gonna provide the spark? Who's it gonna be?
Bret Hart going to work on Goldust, a rake in the face. Goldust setting up the Hitman for the ride. Reversal now. Off the ramp. Right body and Bret Hart, along with the Hart Foundation in the ring. And the celebration is on here in Edmonton, Alberta, before the capacity crowd. We'll see you next week, ladies and gentlemen, deep in the heart of Texas.